Hello everyone and welcome back to another video from Trainsim TV. My name's Tom and today we're going to be having a look at the all new released Northeast England version 2 from DP Simulations. For those of you who have seen this already, we did stream this on the Friday evening as the route was released during our stream. Again, massive thanks to Darren for allowing us to do this and working together on this one. It's been a massive labour of love for Darren this route, and as you will see as we drive through this route, we're going to be doing a run from Nunthorpe all the way over to Bishop Auckland, which covers the all new 20 miles of the route. We'll be doing a run down to Middlesbrough non-stop through this first section, and then we'll be starting our service from Middlesbrough and covering all the route between to Darlington, and then we'll start on our new section on the branch line up to Bishop Auckland, looking at all the key features, new assets and bits and pieces along the way. So we're going to get ourselves set up and get ourselves straight into the drive. I must apologise as well, there might be odd coughs in the video. I'm still not quite fully over me man flu, as you would call it, but we are getting there. Still a bit of a tickly cough, but we will just have to soldier on, as they say. Alright, straight into the cab, and we are on an imminent departure on this run. So we're just gonna get our cab set up and then we'll get going. Excuse me. Alright. It's a 15 mile an hour speed restriction, and as you can see at the end of the double section, we're going to single line, and the incline going, well, the descent in the gradient is quite harsh, as you can see there, so we have to keep our eye on the braking. I've not driven going the other way coming up to Nunthorpe yet. It looks quite a challenge, quite full in steam lock, I must say. DPSimulation's website. The link will be provided in the description for the video, so you can pick it up from there. We're up into a 30 mile an hour section now. I'm not going to put too much power on. I'm not going to set my GSMR until we get to Middlesbrough, because we're on the semaphore section. We don't know what the signals are, but we do start our service there, so we'll get everything else properly set up when we get to that station. Roll down the hill, put a little bit of braking on. We do have a 20 mile an hour speed drop for the crossing just before Gypsy Hill. We level ourselves back out while we go through Gypsy Hill platform. Quite an interesting crossing as well. It's bollarded up, so there's no vehicles actually cross over there. It's just pedestrian. And again, as we travel through Gypsy Hill, the descent in the gradient starts once again. A bit longer this time, opposed to the last one we just did. We do go from 30 to 50 mile an hour in a moment. I'm also going to see how well we can do without driving with the HUD for a change. It's always an interesting one. Noise with that draft. You will have seen that we have streamed bits of this route prior to its release, and we have covered it in odd videos. We have never covered this section of the route, and we never covered the full run to Bishop Auckland. One of the runs we have done on our stream was where we took a Class 67 from Thornaby up to Hyington, which is the new Hitachi depot at Merchant Park. Station is 2 o'clock once again. Not so harsh this time, but there's still quite a drop. Again, as well, the route has been built in such a manner where Darren works, where it's more focused in the cabin tent drive. So plenty of detail from the driver's eye view, but the scenery doesn't go millions of miles away from the car. This also does aid with the SPS. And at the end of the day, it's a training and driving simulation based game. You're not really going to be looking at a village 5 miles up the road. You should be looking, of course, at the track. So the key focus is in the cabin. This is James Cook as well. Quite interesting names on these platforms on this line. Travelling towards Middlesbrough now. Should be our next stop. And we'll begin our service. Our service is 2 Delta 1 5 10 10 Middlesbrough to Bishop Auckland. On this service, we'll be calling Middlesbrough, Thornaby, Eaglescliff, Allen's West, Dinsdale, Darlington, North Road, Hyington, Newton Aycliffe, Shildon, and Bishop Auckland. Scenarios on top of what came with version 1, but Darren will be working on extra scenarios which will feature onto his website. These extra scenarios will go into the East Coast Mainline collection when they have been done and uploaded. So do keep an eye out on that. Do like this. I'm just gonna pause here for a moment because I love stuff like this, where we have all these custom road signs in the route. So obviously this is Middlehaven, this junction. So obviously Teesport, Red Car, Whitby, Middlehaven, North Ormsby, Middlesbrough College, and the football stadium, which is Riverside Stadium, Temenos. You can see the industry starting to roll in as well on the right hand side here. One thing I always praise Darren for is his motorway junctions and stuff like that. He does a fantastic job of them. Very convincing. I can never achieve this. It annoys me. I might go for this as a screenshot, actually. Possible. I would have taken a couple before I started the video. I'm always on hunt for a good screenshot for my thumbnail on YouTube, you see, so... You'll always hear me clicking away at screenshots. Dropped down to 30 mile an hour now. the line from Saltburn, which comes in from the right-hand side. All the steel industry and stuff like that's down that way as well. If you've got trains in World, obviously you can go that way on that route, on the Tees Valley line, which is a 1980s version, but it's a very good route as well. We're in the 25 mile hour section now, and we are just coming to the platform at Middlesbrough. One of many custom stations and custom assets on the line. Right, so first things first, we need to put Bishop Auckland, I think it's 102. That's a good remember, because I did this on Friday night, I'm still trying to remember this. So we are 2 Delta 15. Can't remember the signal number though. 672. We're registered. So just whilst we're waiting, we've got a little bit of time. One of the things that Darren prides himself on is his era-specific signage. So we are obviously on current era, so we've got Trans-Pennine Express signs. There is a YouTube tutorial which covers how to do this signage. It's very, very easy. There will be a link. It'll pop up in the right-hand corner anytime now. If you do wish to have a look at how you do that, do check that video out. This is the custom station, as I said. There's quite a few stations in this version where they are custom as well, so we'll see quite a few of these on our run. Welcome to Middlesbrough. Please ensure you keep your personal belongings with you at all times. This line did also used to have a through road, I think. It is like it has got actual room in the centre for a possible extra track. I could be wrong there, but it does look like it did have a through road at one point. So Class 66 just rolling around the back of the platform with a coal train. So we'll get ourselves into our cab now and prepare for our departure, as we are quite close. It's 27 miles to Bishop Auckland. Bearing in mind it's 27 miles, about 30 miles I think from where we started, but don't forget some of the route is already existing. So the bit from, if we go into the map, we'll see what's new as well. So we started over here. This line down here, where we join is here. This is on the existing part of the route at Bosefield Junction area. Then all this down here is existing, but we start the new section again here, just near North Road. still in the 25 mile an hour section. We'll do open back up to 60 in a moment. We'll go through the speed sign. And then it drops back down to 45 just like that. I don't think anyone could have got to 60 mile an hour in that speed, in that time. Now we do open up to 60 miles per hour, just as we overtake the class 66 here. Our next stop is Thornaby. We're just approaching Tees Yard as well. Back down to 45. Always on the hunt for a screenshot, as I say. You never know what might come in handy. It would have been a lot nicer if we had the Class 66 in the background there as well, could have made a bit more of a nice shot out of that. And Tees Yard on the right side. Just now. Not as bustling as it once was, sadly. Drop down to 35 miles per hour now. It's amazing to see how much the station's changed. When you look at Train Sim World, it was a full-on platform where you could actually walk between the whole lot. Today it's actually got a car park in the centre of the platform. It just shows how much this area has changed and the station. So it's also got custom station building assets this as well. The ramp for the cars to come down and the footbridge. It's a nice little platform. I'm going to pause that for a second just so we're not out of time. I do like how the road's been done here. All the bollards as well. It's a nice detail. It's got a little compound area sort of on the end of the ramp here. Little cabin box here. Something for engineers possibly. Some little sleepers as well. This is a custom footbridge as well. Custom walls. I think I'm not quite sure if the walls are custom down the side of the tracks here, but again, you've got a custom wall which comes down obviously from the road level there. Oh, next stop is Eagles Cliff. I love this bridge coming up here. I mentioned this in previous videos, but I think the bridge is absolutely fantastic. I love the texturing work on it. I'm just coming to the Bolesfield Junction. Take the line to the right here, that can take you onwards towards Hartlepool, the Durham coast. Just join the line from Hartlepool. Carrying on this line, you can get down to the East Coast Main Line 2 way. You can go down towards North Hamilton, or you can take the line which we're going to be taking and head over to Darlington. approaching Eagles Cliff now. So Eagles Cliff as well is another custom station on the route. I love this station. I like how Trace of Wills, where you can actually walk up the ramp as well and put little newspapers or something up here as well and then head back down. Excuse me. So again, if you carried on, you can get to North Halton that way and head south. To head north, you would take this line. So it's a 30 mile an hour section, this one. Just have to check them. Make sure I didn't miss any speed boards. Next stop is Allen's West. Section now, and the station is just approaching. So at the moment we're currently travelling on the section for version 1. We'll be following this section to Darlington and then we'll be taking the new section from just leaving Darlington, heading north, and then we'll take the northwest line towards Bishop Auckland. Is Dinsdale in 4.3 miles. On our way to Dinsdale we'll pass through Teesside Airport Station. So all the stations that get covered on this new section, on this new version, are Nunthorpe, Gypsy Lane, Marton, James Cook, Middlesbrough, Thornaby. Also features Teesyard. We of course then travel through the version 1 section. The new stations then begin again from North Road, Hightington, Newton Aycliffe, Shildon, Bishop Auckland, and there so. Requirements for the route have not changed at all since version 1, but I will go through these with you. They are the European Local Asset Path from Steam, West Coast Financial Valley from Steam, East Coast Main Line to Peterborough from Steam, East Coast Main Line York to Peterborough from Steam, Local Manchester from Steam Store, and finally the Weardale Teesdale Network from Steam. Airport is just on our left here. Welcome to Teesside Airport Station. I'm going to show you one of the other things with Darren's era-specific signs. It's not just signs that get changed, it's some cosmetics around stations as well that can be seen to change. One being that the footbridge on this station is actually coming down now. So Darren's actually got scaffolding in place to keep the structure stable, which I think is really, really cool. I don't think I've ever seen anything really with scaffolding. I think the only other thing with scaffolding I've ever seen is on the AP 309 Volume 2 at Brighton, where they've put scaffolding all around the actual platform. Other than that, this is the other thing I can think of that has scaffolding, which is really cool. Other things I like to look at is like the old Northern Rail station signs have been actually stickered over. The route is quick drive compatible, as quick drives have come with it, extra ones have been added for the new section, along with a couple, one new one for the old section, which takes you from Hallgate to Teesyard. On top of the quick drives as well, you do get 6 scenarios for the route. Which cover all sorts of bits and pieces, passenger workings, freight workings, special workings. The Dinsdale station as well. Next stop is Darlington. Currently speeding towards the East Coast Main Line. We will join the line just outside Darlington. Might have slowed down a little bit too early there. We're going for a single yellow, which means we're going to be held just before the East Coast Main Line for a passing service. So as we wait here, we'll head over to the main line. We'll watch our AI pass that we're going to be waiting for. Then we'll join our train and we'll drive into Darlington. Yeah, so we're going to be heading into platform 4 at Darlington. So the line from the south joins in to the left here. We're now heading in the northerly direction. One thing I am unsure of on this platform is stopping positions. I'm not sure if to go to the end or if it's this end. I'm going to go with here. If we have a look at our map, see where we are now. We're over here. We've got to cover, this is the new section we're going to cover next. I'm going to travel to Bishop Auckland. Journey distance to Bishop Auckland is 11 miles. So the fade from the signal stating B for Bishop Auckland, which shows the line we are about to take. We are going to drop down to 25 mile an hour in a second. We will adhere to this speed to around just after North Road. You can just see and feel the amount of detail that Darren puts into this route and the love and effort he's put into his project. In all the assets and all the line side detailing, he's not scrimped and scraped on it. He really has put so much work into it this year. Every day talking with him, I mean, he did take a bit of time out to do some scenario work on other routes for a month or so, the back end of the year. He only really sort of revived working back into the project to get it finished about a month or so. Maybe two at the most month prior to its release, which took place obviously on Friday, the 13th of December. It was really he has really put the work in. Not just obviously doing the building, because he's had to do all the custom assets alongside at the same time. So his the workload has been shared between two bits. I do get that a bit wrong as well, so it's 35 for a bit as well. It was 25 throughout. Just arriving at North Road now as well. Quite a bit of history at North Road. Obviously, Tornado was built here, and they are currently building the P2, which should be, I believe, is called the Prince of Wales. This has been built here now as well. So quite a lot of history happens in the workshop behind the station. It starts at 20 mile an hour at the front of the station. It's quite an interesting station, this, the way it looks. The canopy as well. First time I pulled into this station, I thought you had to stop in the canopy, so I got that totally wrong. Actually, stop at this side. I might have stopped a bit shy at that, actually. Got that totally wrong. Oh no, we're in. That's fine. So yeah, stuff like, again, the station signage, you get these little line maps of the Bishop line map. This is the workshop where Tornado and the P2 have an R being built. Little compound area. On the background of this bit, obviously something to do with the works area, where it was an old bit of line that existed once before it's been saved, I'm not overly sure. So, I do know that there is somewhere, I think it's in this section, there is a sign somewhere stating the Stockton and Darlington Railway. I can't remember where it is. Let's see if I can find it. Now, I actually cannot remember for the life of me where that sign lived. I thought it was on this bit somewhere. I might be wrong. It could have been on the East Coast Mainline section, actually. Keep my apples. might have been on the other line, possibly. I think we'd have passed it by now. Next station is Hightington, so we'll be just after the Merchant Park and the test track, so we'll have a look at that as well. Back in the heyday as well, this line was actually the East Coast Main Line diversionary route, so you would have seen Deltics on this route. Just coming up to the end of the test track now, which is going to come up on our left hand side at the moment. You can just see the buffers in the air in the distance. So this is where units such as the 800 series are built and assembled. I think 385 has possibly also been built or worked on here. Actually access the yard from the main line, well, this branch. Approaching the station as well, and the line obviously turns off to the left down to the yard and compound area. Whilst we are loading, this is a staggered platform as well, by the way. I like the signal. I might as well pause that for a couple. Just gonna pause that. So the yard here at Merchant Park is, of course, electrified on certain lines. I think these are the signs where the trains have like approved and ready for shipping out. Obviously the stuff that's on test would come on these lines. You've got a loco unit wash, then you've got your depot here. As far as I'm aware, the doors do not open. You can't drive into the depot, as much as I'm aware. It's just more for cosmetic and looks. It's actually inspired the next as well on the front of the building there. quite a cool place. Be nice when it's filled up with 800s and other bits and pieces in scenarios. Next stop is Newton Aycliffe. Another custom asset on the route, so the whole platform itself and the footbridge is all custom. It's quite a cool station. This has got wooden slats, but then as well it's also got felt on the centre of the platform. Sharn that one actually. Not good. Bad Tom. Excuse me. You like the footbridge quite cool. I like that scratched effect as well on the paintwork on the insides. That's quite cool. Next stop will be Shildon. Shildon, you can change here for the National Railway Museum Locomotion Centre. Thank you. 6-6 there, pulling what looks to be possibly some stored Caledonian sleepers, rolling stock on the way there, are we? This is another cluster, I'd say. This bridge. Actually, go there for a. It's a possible screenshot there. It might have come from the way there, it'll actually itself, I'm not overly sure. We'll have a look at the National Railway Museum building in a moment. The little line that the Railway Museum has as well there. Pause it for a minute. So this is another custom asset that Darren's provided with the route, which is locomotion. As far as I'm aware, the doors aren't animated. You can, if you wish to, actually put some stuff inside here so you can see on the way out. These are actually attached to the track at all times. These come obviously with the I think the Weardale route, so these have just been attached as statics to the route, but they give you something to see as you're driving by. You can of course add your own bits and pieces to it if you wish to do so in your own scenarios. Our next and final stop is Bishop Auckland. Thank you. So as we approach our way into Bishop Auckland, I hope you agree with myself that this is an absolutely stunning, picturesque route. You're definitely going to gain hours of enjoyment out of, especially with the new section now where it opens even more opportunities for services and freight as well. It's shaping to be a fantastic route network. I look forward to seeing where Darren takes it next. I've been told a few things where Darren wants to take it next. I'm not going to stay in the video because he might change his mind, but obviously we will see when the time comes where Darren wishes to share his updates again of where he's working. The line straight ahead there will take you to the Weardale Railway. The line actually does end just around the bend. The other platform is there for the Heritage Railway, so you could put your own AI in there if you do wish to do so. This is Bishop Auckland, and this is another custom station building that Darren's built for the route. So just before we open the doors and finish the scenario off, we're just going to have a little look around the area here. So of course the station building that Darren's built, some lovely texturing again on this one, very nice car part work as well. I love how it does his curbs. I love it, it's absolutely fantastic. Stairway down there as well, that's cool. It's a route that oozes with detail and oozes with atmosphere, and I hope you've really enjoyed watching this video. I've really enjoyed sharing it with you and building up to the release for Darren as well. Once again, massive thanks to Darren for allowing us to do so. Hope you've enjoyed the video once again. Massive thanks for joining us and watching. Please do follow us and subscribe to us. Don't forget to leave us a comment, some feedback. We do like to hear back from you and your thoughts. Don't forget you can follow us on Twitch at twitch.tv/trainsimtv_Tom and twitch.tv/trainsimtv_Mark. My channel, which is Tom, of course, you'll catch me most usually on a Wednesday and a Thursday. The times have changed from 7:30 to an 8 o'clock slot at the moment, which will most likely be staying there for a good while. but if they do change, we will let you know in of course in the correct methods and channels. So we'll leave you there with that one, guys. We do hope you enjoyed, and we'll see you again soon for the next video. Take care and goodbye for now.